Hi, I'm Alicia. Welcome to our 9-part video series, 76 proven tactics to drive traffic to your website. Today, we'll be talking about keyword research. So you've got your site all set up, but you're unsure how to drive traffic to your website. This video series is devoted to showing you 76 tried and true methods to do just that. We're covering topics such as content marketing, creating communities, social media, and more. But before we get too far, remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content, such as videos in this series. And I want you to know that in the description, we're going to have loads of resources that'll dive deeper into many of the topics I'll be presenting today. All right, let's get started. Keyword research is the process of finding relevant phrases or keywords that your audience is searching for. Once you have a list of keywords, you want to include them in pages with the intention of these pages showing up in search engines. There are lots of ways to generate keywords using both free and premium tools. Number 35 on our list, target topics with traffic potential. SEO is one of the best ways to send consistent traffic to your blog. But to get Google to send visitors your way, you need to be showing up for the right keywords. In other words, you need to target keywords with traffic potential. After all, you want your traffic to look like this. The metrics you want to keep in mind when doing keyword research are search and global volume, how many people are searching the keyword each month, and keyword difficulty, how difficult the keyword will be to rank for. There are lots of free and paid keyword research tools available. Here are some of the best. Arif's Keyword Explorer, SEM Rush, KW Finder, Uber Suggest, Google Keyword Planner, Keyword Sheeter. Long-tail keywords are 3+ word phrases that are very specific to whatever you're selling or the information you're providing on your blog. Here's an example. Notice how as the keyword becomes longer and more specific, the conversion rate increases. This is one of the benefits of long-tail keywords, along with the fact that they're often easier to rank for because they're less competitive. So how do you find long-tail keywords? Well, it's pretty easy to do so without ever leaving Google. Here are 3 quick methods to find long-tail keywords. First up is autocomplete. Just start typing out your main keyword or topic and let Google generate suggestions based on what other people have been searching for. If you scroll down a bit on the results page, you'll see the next long-tail keyword research method, the People Also Ask box. And finally, at the bottom of the page is the searches related to suggestions. Boom! That's 3 ways of doing long-tail keyword research using only Google. As we mentioned earlier, you really want to be writing about things people are asking. 2 great tools for finding these question-based keywords are Answer the Public and QuestionDB. Just drop in your keyword and you'll get loads of question ideas. Here are the results for the keyword credit card on Answer the Public. And here are the results on QuestionDB. As you can see, from just 1 keyword, you can generate lots of potential questions you can turn into articles that people in your niche are asking. This is just a fancy way of saying, find keywords you don't rank for that get a high amount of monthly searches. And then, you guessed it, try to rank for them. The quickest way to find keyword gaps is with Arif's. Here's a quick walkthrough. Fire up the Arif's Content Gap tool and drop in the domains you want to compare. Hit Show Keywords and you'll see many potential keyword gaps. If you do this for your site and a few of your competitors, you'll be able to see all the keywords they rank for, but you do not. Based on your competitors, you'll be able to prioritize the keyword gaps to go after and try and rank for. LSI, which stands for Latent Semantic Indexing, also sometimes referred to as semantic keywords, are words and phrases that are related to your main keyword. Since Google Hummingbird, the search engine has put more importance on understanding a topic fully, LSI keywords are a good way to help the search engine crawlers. You can use a tool like LSI Graph to find them. Just drop in your main keyword, and it will give you a list of terms related to your topic. Try to add these to your articles and pages. To be honest, if you're writing good content, you will be including semantic keywords anyway, but it's worth keeping in mind. Keyword cannibalization is when two or more pages on your website are competing against themselves by trying to rank for the same term. It's actually quite common, especially with large sites with lots of pages. We'll link to a detailed article from Moz about it in the description. The lesson to learn here is that you want to avoid keyword cannibalization as it can confuse Google. It won't know which page it should rank. Having two similar pages competing against one another is not helpful for driving traffic. It can also lower the authority of your page, dilute any links you have to the pages, and impact your conversion rate. Often, you will be better off consolidating these into one post. You can use a free spreadsheet, again, linked in the description, to find keyword cannibalization and run a quick keyword query to surface potential issues. Here's a quick traffic win you can do if you have an existing site. Find pages that are performing relatively well and then improve them to give them a boost. Let me explain. Pages and keywords that are ranking around the top of page 2 or the bottom of page 1 are ideally suited. These may just need a few tweaks to get them to climb up the ranks and send more traffic to your site. Some ways you can improve these easy win keywords include doing keyword research to target terms better, improving your on-page SEO, adding more content, pointing internal links to the page, building some backlinks to the page. To find these pages, you can use the built-in keyword filtering of SEO tools like Arifs or SEMrush. And again, use some free SEO spreadsheets for SEO tasks or go through the performance report in Google Search Console. The key aspect here is giving people a compelling reason to sign up. Take some of the tactics from this series and apply them to your site, and you'll be well on your way to increasing traffic. Try them out. See what effect they have on your site traffic, and if one doesn't work for you, try another. And if it does, double down and do more. Which tactics have you tried? Where have you seen success in driving traffic to your site? Let us know in the comments below. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to get notifications for the remaining videos in this series, and of course, other tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.